apparently this story is taught in Danish schools and is, you know, it's a huge history. Is that what attracted you to the role?
Well, actually, I never learned it in school, this story, but it's part of our history. Everybody knows about it. But how many details is very individual. Everybody knows about this guy, Stolze, the doctor, the German doctor who took over the country, had an affair with the queen, got a baby, and he got beheaded. But the details, that's very individual, how much people know.
So can you tell us a bit about your character then?
Well, my character is a German doctor called Johann Friedrich Struensen, and he works in a Danish province in Germany. He gets the chance of being the king's physician. The king is a very sick man mentally. He's what we call total lunatic. At that time, they didn't know exactly what they should do with him, so he was just a little puppet. He was manipulated by all the ministers. And I take the job, and I find him extremely interesting. And I try to open him up, find the key to him. And one of the keys is that he should stand his ground, and he should speak up for himself, and he should start interfering with the ministers and say what he wants. And during that process, I discover that people are whispering in his ear. And I get a splendid idea that maybe I should whisper in his ear a little, twice, three times.
Ten.
And that becomes 10, yeah, of course. And before you know it, he's taking over the country. And that's what really happened.
Great. I also read that the story has become like a ballet and an opera. Mm-hmm. You used to be a dancer, is that right?
I used to be.
Really? Can you tell me a bit about that?
Yeah, I can tell you. I was a dancer for 9 years. I was a gymnast before that. And then I got a chance to be in a show in the background, you know, jumping up and down and do flips and that. Mm-hmm. The choreographer asked me if I wanted to learn the craft, and I had absolutely nothing else to do, so I became a dancer.
So might we see you in the ballet version of A Royal Affair?
20 years ago, maybe.
Maybe.
I might be the old king in that one.
So back to the film, how did you hear about it? Did the director approach you?
Yeah, Nikolai, the director, he called me. I knew him from before. I never worked with him. And he said that he had this script that he wanted to finally make this film that everybody's been trying to make for 50 years. Mm-hmm. I got it, I read it, and I was very touched by what I read, which is a rare thing when you read a script, and then even more rare when you read a period piece like this. Mm-hmm. You always have to dig in between the costumes and the wigs to find something in there. But this was very, very touching, and so that was a definitely yes from the beginning for me.
You play quite an intense character. How did you prepare for the role?
Well, I prepared like I always do. I mean, what we're doing is the script, that's the story, and I prepare a little extra on the sides, reading something else and getting inspired by that. But as I said before, I love the script, so you take scene by scene and you figure out how we're going to approach it. And there was some heavy stuff in there, but there's also a lot of love in it. I mean, there's a lot of love between the characters, all three of them, and so it was not only a tragedy to be in the film, we actually had some great days as well.
What was one of your favorite scenes to film?
Oh, I have a couple of nice scenes with the king, where I'm so proud of him, where he's standing his ground, and I think he's so proud of doing it, and there were some really beautiful scenes there, but I'm not the big romantic, but I kind of fell for the dance scene with the big prom and all the dresses, and we are actually dancing in a film. I thought that was quite nice to do.
What would you say your relationship is with Hollywood? Because you've done all these huge big films, and then you've also done a lot of foreign.
I'm engaged with Hollywood. No, I have a relationship with Hollywood, which is if they offer me something and I find it interesting, I do it, and if I don't, I don't do it. That's as easy as it is back home. It's the same back home, it's the same in Germany or in France, wherever happens. Mm. If there's something I find I have to do, I'll do it.
Yeah.
And if not, I'll just stay home and have a vacation.
So there's no preference with staying in Europe or?
No, my base is here, my family's here. I mean, and most of the American productions are shot somewhere in Europe anyway, so if I placed my family over there, I would never see them. So I would be over here working somewhere.
And what else are you working on at the moment? You seem to have millions of things in pre-production and post-production.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff. If you read the IMDb thing, I'm doing a lot of stuff. Most of it I've never heard of. But I am going to shoot a film called The Necessary Death of Charlie Countryman, and we're going to shoot that in Bucharest.
Great. When can we expect to see you in that then?
Well, that will be a while, maybe next
year. You've not started shooting yet?
No, no, we're going to shoot in May, but before that, there will be later this year a release of Thomas Vinterberg's new film that we shot just before Christmas.